Broadcasting from the Gaylord Rockies Resort in Denver, Colorado, Solutions Review is on location at Commvault Go 2019. Brought to you by Commvault.
It's Doug Atkinson back here on day two of Commvault Go's customer conference. And customer conferences not only have customers and Commvault executives, certainly, they also have partners. And we're lucky to be joined by one because it's really an important element in the entire implementation process, and we'll get into that a little bit with Damon Robertson, who's the managing director of COOLSPIRiT from the UK.
Yeah, hello, Doug.
Hello.
Good to meet you.
Nice of you to come over and visit Denver.
It's been fantastic. Yeah, loving it. Loving,
excellent.
Yeah, I've worn the attire as well.
You do. You look very indigenous.
I was told to wear a check shirt and boots.
So was I, but you can't really see it. Well, thanks for being here, because I really actually wanted to dig in a little bit on the role of a partner in an implementation, because I believe there's really three important elements to a good implementation. It's not just the customer and the solution, but it is a partner. But before we do that, give us a little bit of your history and how you came to be, at this place at this time in the backup industry, because you've in our pregame chat here, you really span the evolution.
Yeah. So yeah, we've jumped a lot of paradigms, a lot of paradigm shifts. So 20 years ago, the inception of COOLSPIRiT, we were a tape provider. So tapes and tape libraries, that was our game. We had 5 years of doing that, and really the always on society changed that. So we moved more into a disk-based backup for speed of restore. So we had to change our game, although it was still a fairly simple sale to us. People saw that they were buying a solution, so we had to change our game really from more of a consumable tape player to a solutions provider. And way back 2006, 2007, we put our first deduplication device in, and then spanning out from there, we looked for a backup vendor, went through a few, kissed a few frogs, and finally in 2008 met Commvault. And we've had a marvelous career with Commvault since.
Well, and it's an amazing journey actually since then, right? I mean, you've seen, and we're amazed at how we've been to three of these Commvault Goes, and in just those 3 years, they've announced several new offerings this year particularly. But you've seen really the last 10 years an incredible.
Yeah. We've taken it from Simpana 8/9. The evolution of Commvault 10 through to 11 and then forwards. So yeah, we've seen massive evolution at Commvault.
So tell me how you're working with your customers to deliver a solution like a Commvault. Do you have some examples of how you're implementing Commvault and where you fit in and what you bring to the table?
Yeah. So Commvault backup in general, people don't change the backup. It's a bit like the death, divorce, etc. They just don't change the backup. It's usually last on the list until they hit a problem. So we can be knocking on the door for many years. So you must change your backup for this reason, must change your backup. And then suddenly they say, actually, virtualization's happened, clouds happen, etc. There's a change. And that's when they go, I remember those guys. Those guys who supply tape. Let's have a chat with them. We come in, we talk to them, and we take it through. We generally do a health check on their environment, what current backup provider they're looking at, or using, so I should say. And then we look at maneuvering Commvault in. Now that might be a cloud-driven conversation. It could be a data center, a hybrid cloud conversation. The one we're really finding at the moment is Activate. That's causing a lot of interest around compliance and the solution provider there.
Well, and in the UK, that's a real issue.
With the big GDPR, there was a lot of companies looking at that, and the content indexing in Commvault's perfect for that. So that is a good conversation starter. Then they look at the backup and restore, then Office 365, then the cloud, and Commvault, generally customers say, and can it do this? And we say, yeah. And can it do that? Yeah. So it's a good progressional sale. And then eventually they invite us in to look at a solution. Our support desk gets involved in that, looking at how they're doing things now and how they can do it differently. And we put some, we've got the extra mile in making sure that the benefits of the new solution come forward. And then they make a choice.
Well, so do you have any concrete examples? I'm curious about, you know, maybe a customer case or something that where you can kind of show our audience is typically buyers.
By chance, yesterday, perfect timing.
Excellent.
A very large telecom companies in the UK, completely on-prem. They don't want to do anything in cloud at the moment.
Right.
Using Veeam for 3 years, we've been knocking on the door saying, Commvault's better, come on, guys. Anyway, they hit the pain point. They've made an acquisition who have got some cloud. They've made an acquisition where they're using a different database and app. And Veeam, their current provider, is creaking. It's running slowly. It doesn't do the integration with this app they've bought. So they invited us in and said, will you come and have a chat? When we got on to Activate, they sort of sat back and went, we know there's another project to do this. This is good. They changed the project completely. They called it 5 years out. They asked us for the Commvault roadmap, where it was now, where Activate is now, where it'll be in 3 years. And they went, this fits with where we're going. Can you do as a POC? So we've had engineers in working for about a month, showing them the products, POCing in a live environment as well, which is quite unusual. Our support desk have been supporting them throughout this. And then yesterday, lo and behold, the order turned up.
So nice.
On a Cisco, it's going on Cisco UCS, layered with Commvault over the top.
Congratulations.
So that'll be implemented over the next 6 to 8 weeks.
Well, that's excellent. It's always nice to be able to do business when you're on the road.
It's lovely. It was a great phone call.
Well, I'm curious, you know, we have an event like this. There's a lot going on all around us here. This is very well designed in that they keep everybody in the room.
Yes, yeah.
What do you hope to get out of, you know, 2 or 3 days in Denver?
I've got two things out of this that I'm going to take back to our end users. One is the confidence that the Commvault USA end users have got in Commvault. They think the support's excellent, the product roadmap's good. Again, that question I was saying before, does it do this? And you're able to say yes straight away. Does it cover Office 365? Can it back up Teams? All these new things that are coming along that other backup products can't do. So I'm looking forward to taking that confidence back. But one thing that's really stood out for me is the Hedvig acquisition.
Yeah.
I was aware of Hedvig before, but talking to the guys over there, we've had an in-depth demo. But what came out of it was their customers are very, very similar to Commvault customers. They're not easy 2 terabyte, 5 terabyte environments where they've got one site. Our customers, Commvault customers, as I say, are multi-data center, multi-cloud, different applications, and very different problems and solutions. And Hedvig customers are very similar. So I'm looking forward to taking the Hedvig guys into our Commvault customers and having those conversations.
Yeah, that was the big announcement earlier in the year is the acquisition by Commvault of Hedvig. And it really is, you can feel a very different vibe from Commvault these days with that. I mean, it's a very modern... a modern solution.
Yeah, it's always been great with Alan Bob, absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And now it seems to have gone more Silicon Valley, more entrepreneurial.
Right.
It's gone up a couple of gears.
Yeah.
But what's nice is that rock solid stability is still there. So not moving away from what Alan Bob created.
No, and I think the Hedvig guys made a very deliberate decision based upon that rock solid Commvault story, that they were cool joining up.
Yeah, so we're excited about that. We'll see where it goes.
Well, so before I let you go, what advice would you offer? You know, we're looking into 2020. A lot of our audience is starting to make plans. Some are beginning to think about, you know, maybe getting to the next level, looking at a next level solution. What advice would you give to somebody in that consideration stage?
Yeah, it's something, Doug, that I heard at one of the campfires. USA reseller who worked for a bank said, whatever you do, if you are considering moving your backup software, choose a trusted partner. That will go the length. And as I was saying with our recent order yesterday, we took them right through that journey. So the confidence is there. And also the guy's been dealing with the same reseller for 5 years, and he if he does have to escalate, he knows the reseller will escalate for him, and he knows they're proactive. He was saying they're very proactive in telling me what's coming in Commvault, so that he doesn't have to go out and research and think Teams that I mentioned, does it back up Teams? Quick call to the reseller. Yes, it does. Let me come and give you a demo, etc. Choose a really good partner with a rock solid and now entrepreneurial Commvault, and a really good partner with a good support desk. Can't fail.
Yeah, no, and actually that gets back to my original question, and it's certainly something that I think is a subtle piece of advice, but I think maybe the most important piece of advice is consider the three elements: you, the solution, but also that partner that's going to get bridge the gap,
the glue,
and be with you beyond just the licensing.
Yeah, our customers have been with us 15 years on
tape, right.
20 years. The Commvault customers, 8 years old. Some are 10 years old.
Yeah, and you're the ones now that pick up the phone at the end of the day.
We look after them.
We look after them
and give them a human touch and some love.
Outstanding. Well, I'm glad you stopped by. Great advice.
No, thanks.
We appreciate it very much. Thanks.
Okay, lovely. Thank you.